Hello everyone. Thank you very much for joining our next virtual summit 2021. My name is Max Janzen. I have worked for Zurich, Germany for 7 years now, and I lead the project Broker Transformation within the Distribution and Partnership Department. And together with Guillermo, I'm the External Connection Co-Lead of Next. Today, we invited several speakers to our opening session to introduce you to our Global Zurich Initiative Next. Next is a grassroots movement within Zurich promoting intergenerational dialogue. In brief, the shape of workforce is changing. By 2025, 75% of global workforce will be millennials. With Next, we give a voice to newer generations to future-proof our company globally and to shape our legacy. Our next virtual summit starts today and it will take place from 15 to 19 November 2021. Joined by changemakers, senior leaders, entrepreneurs, and Zurich speakers, we will bring people together to share insights, to support the intergenerational dialogue, and to inspire you to take actions wherever you are to solve challenges and to drive change. Our agenda for the week deals with Next-related topics like next generation of work, next generation of climate and earth, and next generation of society and social innovation. We would like to do the session interactive as much as possible, and please use our Q&A session and ask a lot of questions. At first, Penny Seach, our Chief Underwriting Officer EMEA, will share your insights about Next from a senior leader perspective of Zurich. And Penny, thank you for joining us, and the stage is yours.
Thanks, Max, and morning, everyone, and a very warm welcome to the summit. It's going to be a fantastic summit, so I really hope that you can put aside everything that's going on, really immerse yourself and really enjoy it. So I've just got a couple of minutes. I talk a lot, so I'm going to get straight into it. And bringing a lens as a senior leader, obviously based within Zurich, to Next, and, you know, kind of the relevance and why am I excited and committing and being a part of this, right? And I think one of the things that we tend to do as leaders within an organization, especially as we do tend to get more senior, is we spend a lot of time thinking about how we remain relevant primarily to our customer base. But one thing that strikes me from a personal perspective is that there's always a bias lens to that question. And so a concern is that as we are asking ourselves the question and we're getting the feedback and the responses back, because we have got such a strong sense of self-worth around where we are in our career, which normally is around what we know, we tend to automatically bring a biased lens to that problem. And intellectually, we know that. But unless we are hyper-aware or unless we have forums like Next, it's really difficult to even be conscious of the fact that we are bringing this lens to the problem statements. And so for me personally, this is absolutely the value, the importance of forums like Next. It's an opportunity to balance experience with a perspective, with different ways of thinking, different experiences. It's not just experience in the workplace, but it's life experiences as well. You know, it's about saying, how do we look at a common problem and then look at it through different eyes to see what is the best way of understanding what that problem is before we actually even get on to how do we then solve for that. I love the statements about informed optimism. We're in business because we are optimists broadly by nature, right? But being informed, that is just absolutely the critical crunch. And that's where every single person has a role to play. And again, irrespective of levels of experience. We want to be collaborative. We want to be provocative. I think one of the things that is really important is that we have forums that is a safe environment or a safe area that allows us to be collaborative but provocative with each other. We need forums where we have equal seats at a table. And again, I think that is incredibly important and recognizes that we have different perspectives and different views around the table. And I think one thing that is really interesting for me is to say, you know, what does having a seat at the table really mean, right? It's not just about the networking opportunity or the exposure to senior leaders within the organization. It's really about representing, be it a generation, be it a part of our community, whoever you are representing at that table, it's important that you bring it, right? So in closing, right, I would just say the best experiences that I've had in dialogues is when it's deeply relevant, when it counts, right, when it is crystal clear. So what is it, the perspective that we're trying to bring to the table? Set the frame clearly, set the ground rules really, really clearly, but have an opinion, have an informed opinion. And I would say to you, don't back down, have a voice, right? We all compromise and we all are mature and we listen and we take perspectives from each other, but make sure that your voice is heard. So that would be it for me. Max, I'll hand that back to you.
Thank you very much, Penny. And our next speakers, Nicoletta and Nils, will give you now an overview. How do we deal with this voice, and how? What is our day-to-day work at Next, and what is Next about? So, Nicoletta, thank you for joining us, and now you're live.
Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. I'm Nicoletta Polano, and I'm one of the two liaison co-leads together with Nils. We would like, in a couple of minutes, to give you a brief overview, and then all the other speakers will dive into specific areas and core themes and initiatives of Next. So what is Next about? Max mentioned already, we are a grassroots movement, and we have, let's say, we aim at promoting intergenerational dialogue and next generation representation. The movement started in 2019 with 12 founders. We have Alina also on the call. She will share a bit more details, I guess, later about how everything started and how everything evolved. And nowadays, in 2021, we are around 400 plus people within the global Next community, very active and engaged in all the Next initiatives. But we have around 2000 plus supporters of Next around the world, including senior leaders like Penny. So what are the strategic pillars for Next? So we have three key strategic pillars. The first one is voice, the second one is connection, and the third one is social innovation. So what's in the first pillar, voice? We will hear a bit later from Suzy also a bit more about Next, but just to give you a brief introduction, there are three key initiatives in the voice pillar. First of all, we have the Ask Next initiative. Anyone within Zurich, being it an individual, a senior leader, a team, a function, can engage with Next and ask for feedback, for support, or simply for views on particular projects or initiatives. So you just, we have a form on our SharePoint. You can just simply fill out the form and we will get back at you with potential proposals of collaboration. The second type of initiative within voice is Next Change. You might have heard about it. Some of you might be already participating in the pilot last year or this year. It's our cross-mentoring initiative that aims at connecting globally next-gen participants and senior leaders. Third and last initiative within voice is our Next Views. This is our advocacy pillar, and we have several initiatives under this type of initiative itself. So let's move to the second strategic pillar, that is connection. This trees out in two different areas. So one is internal connection, and the second one is external connection. Within internal connection, we have our hubs. So we have 9 Next hubs within the Zurich world globally, in all based in different regions. And you will hear a bit later from Alex, one of our regional community builders, everything about all these hubs. Then the external connection pillar is the one that, first of all, takes care of organizing this virtual summit. So it's represented by Max and Guillermo. And in addition to that, we also have our signature Next Talks, You might have heard about them, or you might have participated to one of them already. And Max and Guillermo, they also take care of nurturing existing partnerships, but also build new ones with external partners, being it corporations, associations, NGOs, and so on. Last but not at all least of our strategic pillars is social innovation. In the social innovation space, we have a very great collaboration with the Zurich Foundation and One Young World, where we every year we bring a delegation, a joint delegation of Zurich Foundation and next participants to the One Young World Summit. But in addition to that, this is our biggest partnership, but we have several other smaller partnerships in this space that we wish to nurture and develop in the next months and years. Now I leave the floor to Nils for some more information and a bit more flavor to what we do at Next.
Yeah, thank you very much, Nicoletta. Very nice to be on the call and to share a bit more about Next and about our daily work, actually. So as Nicoletta elaborated already about our strategic pillars, I want to give you a sense of what we are doing in our daily Next work, right? So myself, I'm Nils, and I'm working in Zurich, Switzerland. So Nicoletta is working for group compliance. So it's easy for us, at least we have the same time period, right, to work in the same team. But we are a global team. We have representatives in the core team all over the world. And that's the first thing you might know. In a global team, you have time differences. But we work it out. We have every week on Thursday, we have our weekly call. So where we discuss for 1 hour the updates in each area and follow on anything that's going on, right? So this week, obviously, it's heavily influenced by the virtual summit, and here Max and Guillermo have the lead. And but it's in every stage of the year, there's something else going on, and we are trying to support each pillar. And it's very much always going on something, right? And we are delighted to be here on the virtual summit. And I want to share a bit about our key achievements. We are proud to say this year. First of all, we have managed to get an additional seat at the Global Pension Committee with Anne-Kathrin Blanke, who joined the Pension Committee. We have someone from Next that is represented the new generation, right? And Penny already touched base on this. This is really what we aim for, to get the younger generation a seat at the table. And another achievement, we are proud to announce that we are nominated for the Community Hero Awards 2021. For Zurich, and we will soon hear who's the winner, and hopefully it will be Next. So these are just two very quick achievements we are proud to announce for this year, and more to follow next year. So stay tuned, and for more about each individual pillars, I will now hand over to Suzy.
Thanks, Nils, and good morning, good afternoon, good evening to everyone, wherever you're dialing in from. As Penny and Max have already mentioned, it's promising to be a really, really good week. There are a lot of really relevant sessions coming up, and a lot of work has gone into this, so I really, really hope that you enjoy. Nicoletta already touched on NextChange. I'm Suzy Batey. I am one of the voice co-leads, along with Peter Everson, and I look after all things that go on in the voice pillar. And I'm really excited to talk to you today about NextChange. NextChange was a pilot program which was started in 2019, and I was actually a member of the pilot program. So it means a lot for me to be able to look after that initiative now and try and make it the best possible initiative it can be. Nicoletta kind of touched on this already. What is NextChange? It is our global mentoring program. And it's a bit different from a traditional mentoring program. because we really encourage it to be an exchange between the participants. We want it to be really focused on teaching and learning, but for both participants. I think Penny mentioned an equal seat at the table. And that's something that I think is really, really important in this relationship, because it is important to share experiences, to share different perspectives, to ensure that you can both get the most out of your relationship. We've already talked about how Focus Next is on promoting meaningful dialogue and really sharing your different views and opinions. So this is a really, really great forum for both senior leaders and next generation participants to have an open table and have those discussions and have a really comfortable environment to do that in. We are really, really pleased that it's also a truly global experience. Nils has already mentioned how lucky we are as a next team to be able to have these really great conversations within the team across different cultures and different countries. But NextChange also offers that opportunity for the participants that take place. I'm really, really pleased that this year we have had 63 international pairings, and that's represented across 17 different countries. So it just goes to show exactly how global this experience has been for people. And in terms of the pilot program, so we ended up having 18 pairs. There was a lot of work that went into the initial pilot, which we've built on this year. I think the fact that it's grown so much is just a testament to how much work has gone into Next and how open we want this experience to be for so many different people. We've had so much great feedback, which makes me really, really pleased. And it's been really thrilling to hear that people have found the experience to be really open and they can actually have those meaningful conversations, whether you want to talk about career experiences, whether you want to talk about the future of Zurich and how we can really build on that together. It's been great to hear that a lot of effort has gone into both sides and that it is a really, really collaborative experience. In terms of some of the different pairings we've had, they've talked to us in great lengths about the different benefits that they've had from the programme. So I think it's been really, really beneficial, and Penny also mentioned this, about really sharing different lenses across the business. And I think that hearing from senior leaders about how much they've been able to learn as well about the next generation, what's important to them, and what's important to them in terms of how we work as a business, has been really, really eye-opening as well. In terms of NextChange, we have launched in October this year, our latest launch. However, in 2022, we're set to have more bigger and exciting opportunities for participants. So please keep an eye out. We would love to have you take part in the future if you haven't already yet. And that was just a very, very quick summary of NextChange. If anyone has any questions, please feel free to reach out to me at any point. But I would love to pass over to Natasha and Steph now.
Great, thank you, Suzy. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I am coming from Australia in Sydney. My name is Natasha Childs. I'm the alumni of Next. I used to be the regional community builder for APAC, and I came onto the alumni in July. So today, what I'm going to be talking about is a common topic that a lot of the next generation in this community ask is about moving overseas within Zurich. So I started my career in Zurich, UK, and in 2015 I really wanted to move to Australia. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about what worked for me and my journey, and also learning a new culture and embedding myself into that. So back in 2015, it was a little bit scary. I really liked the idea of Australia, but you know, moving away from friends and family and the community that I had seemed really daunting. So the first place I kind of started was asking colleagues. So I had colleagues that had been over to Australia who had worked over there, and I asked them. So that's my first bit of advice, is don't be shy. Reach out to colleagues, ask their advice, what worked for them, what didn't. And the second thing, and going on from what Suzy was saying about the amazing NextChange mentorship program that they have, is I had an amazing mentor in Zurich, London. And they had connections in other countries, like a lot of senior leaders do. They've got their counterparts. That was amazing for me in terms of advocacy and also connections. Doubling upon that was my manager. I was, you know, a little bit afraid to talk about it to my manager at first because I was like, oh no, he's going to be offended that I want to leave. But he was the most amazing advocate as well. And together, my mentor and my manager were key to giving those what I would like to call warm introductions, because it can seem a bit daunting when you're looking at the Global Zurich Job Opportunities website and you see all the opportunities and you see the hiring manager, but you don't really know where to start. And that's where I'd say that part is key, is getting that warm introduction, because then, you know, they can also talk about who you are rather than you having to just reach out blindly. The second part is being really open about, you know, what kind of timeframes you're looking at. So there won't be always an opportunity that will suit you in the next month, but if you can give 6 to 12 months kind of time frame, there's usually going to be an opportunity that will come up for you in that country. Be detailed of what you're looking for, but also be open, because opportunities in other countries aren't always carbon cutouts of what you're doing locally. And then practically look yourself, look on the Zurich job site. That gives a great discussion for those warm introductions. You can go, you know, I've seen this role, what do you think about this? So I would definitely recommend that. And then proactively continue building that overseas relationship with those individuals, because it may not be tomorrow that a role comes up and you need to make sure that you keep front in mind. The other component I'd really recommend doing is researching any visa requirements, asking your local HR team, but also asking the HR team based in the country that you're looking at going to, because you want to make it as easy for your hiring manager as possible, and they don't always have that knowledge. It just makes it as simple as possible, really. But don't feel that you're on the back foot with that. People often, in my experience, when they've applied for visas here, which require sponsorship and funding, people feel that they're on the back foot in terms of negotiation of what they want, in terms of relocation costs and being able to sustain themselves over abroad. So make sure you do research about what salary you need to live in that particular country and the living expenses of that local area. Remember that they're not going to be paying a referral fee or a recruitment fee, so you're definitely not on the back front by going via a visa. And then my experience when I moved over here, I was a little bit worried about how I'd integrate, you know, getting to know a community from scratch, both in work and outside of that. My biggest advice is say yes. Join employee relation groups, say yes to socializing, pick up the phone, go over to people's desks, take up hobbies and interests, because ultimately those are the friends and the deeper connections that you're going to build over time. And don't commit to forever, because you'll never do it. Friends and family will persuade you that it's too far. But also don't commit to suitable time frame. 1 year is probably a little bit too short. You don't want to move overseas and then planning your return straight away. So my biggest advice is say yes and give it a couple of years and see how you go. I'll finish up with saying that I love Australia. I love the culture. It's a beautiful country, the beaches, the mountains. It's such a large country and such with a beautiful culture with the Indigenous people here. I convinced myself that I would do 2 years, and 6 years later, I'm still here and I love it. If anyone would like to reach out to me, I'm happy to answer any questions about my experience. And in the meantime, I'll pass over to Steph Reeves.
Thank you, Natasha. And like you, I am from the UK. I now live in Sydney and I have brown hair, but we're not twins. So just so everyone realises, we're not all the same. My story is not actually going to be about my experience, though, moving to Australia. My experience is going to be as a so-called change maker, I guess, although I probably hadn't seen myself as one until somebody asked me to join the next summit. So sometimes it's, you know, somebody else who can see that in you and not yourself. So 4 years ago, I moved over to Australia by myself. And like Natasha, I didn't know anyone. And so I was looking for ways to grow my network. I had a really small team here. There was just me and my manager. So I thought, you know, I don't know anyone and I need to make sure that my visa gets renewed in 2 years. So how do I become valuable to the business in order to do that? So initially my reasons were kind of quite selfish, but I joined the WIN committee because that was something I was really passionate about. If you don't know what the WIN committee is, that's the organization within Zurich that's made up of employees that are here to support gender equality and really sort of advocate for female employees in the business. And that's something I was really passionate about. So I wanted to network in a way that was authentic and felt real to me, because I'd kind of seen networking as a bit of a dirty word, and, you know, a bit of something schmoozy and sort of going to cocktail parties and things like that. And that really didn't seem like me. So my first tip would be do something that you're passionate about and find your tribe, find the people around you that see the same things as you and want to make changes. About a year into me being on the WIN committee, I actually got asked to chair the committee because I was quite a vocal and passionate person. And so they obviously thought I did quite a good job. So I was obviously really privileged to be in that position. And I saw the opportunity to change the way the committee had actually been working. When I arrived, they were really great advocates for personal development and did a lot of events for women and men to further their career and training courses and things like that. But I really saw the opportunity for us to be having a seat at the table, like Penny said earlier, and we really didn't have that. We didn't have any visibility with HR or the exec team. There was no seat at the decision-making table. So we got together as a committee and thought, you know, how do we actually do that? How do we get there? And so we all sat down, we brainstormed, and we came up with a 3-year plan, because I think it's important to realize that these things, you know, don't happen overnight, and you have to build your credibility, you have to build a reputation, you have to get people on board with you and bring them on the journey. So we decided we needed more members. We needed employees to get behind what we were doing. So we got their feedback. We created surveys. We put on interesting events based on what they were asking us for. And we grew our membership over the years. And we then had information in those surveys that we could go to the business with and say, hey, we have an ear of our employees. We can tell you what we know in the organization and what needs to change. So over time, going from having no relationship to HR or the exec at all, we now appear on the exec meeting twice a year. We can ask them to resolve issues. We can give them feedback of what's going on in the organization. And we're actually able to make change now. And one of the examples recently is we advocated for a domestic and family violence policy to be introduced because it's such a big issue here in Australia. It's a real big community issue. And 2 years ago, the WIN committee decided to have a barbecue and raise some money for a charity that was in the domestic abuse space. And fast forward 2 years later, and the Zed Zurich Foundation have now actually given a grant of $100,000 to that charity for the work that they're doing in the domestic and family violence space. And that wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for the committee members having a barbecue 2 years ago. So you just never know where things are going to take you. And you can be somebody who's on your own in a new country, knows nobody, and then, you know, you just absolutely have no idea. If you just put yourself out there and show passion for something, you really can make the change. So I've got a couple of tips that I think you could benefit from. So I would say really find your tribe, find the senior executives in the business that role model the values that you see and that you want, and go and ask them for help. Go and ask them if they'd be a sponsor or turn up at one of your events. Learn to talk the language of the business. What gets the business results will get you results. So are you solving a problem that's come out of ENPS? Are you providing business value? Is there a gap in the employee experience that you can fill? And talk to the business in the language they know best. Provide solutions and give them tangible results. And I would say consistent and small actions create the pathway to long-term goals. I don't think 2 or 3 years ago when we sat in the room and set that strategy that we would actually be already after such a short time be in the position that we are now. But once that ball gets rolling, you can be surprised at what actually you can achieve. So that would be my advice. Thanks for listening. Thanks for having me here. If you've got any questions about the WIN committee or you want to make changes in your organisation and you'd like to chat more, just let me know and I'll hand over to Alina. Thank you.
Thank you, Steph. So welcome, everyone. My name is Alina. I'm 24 years old and I'm now an ex-alumni. But as Nicoletta introduced myself, I had the pleasure to be one of the founding members. And I often get the question how I got there, how we started Next. So I want to share a bit of my story with you. So when I started at Zurich, it was just straight after school. I was like 19 years old. So Zurich is my first employer ever since. And I did a 4-week internship at Corporate Center. So we have this possibility at Zurich, Germany. And I went there and I had a lot of fun. I really enjoyed the international work. So I came back and was like really, really annoying to my line manager saying I want to do something international. And it wasn't really something I could do from this position, but I really was annoying her all of the time. So when there came an English email, I was just translating it. So doing really basic stuff. And then one day I got a call saying they are doing something at Corporate Center. There is no name yet. We don't really know what they are doing, something around young people. And you would need to go to Zurich for three days or 4 days, I think it was. So I was like, oh, yeah, why not? So I just say yes. And I went to Zurich and we started to build Next, actually. So we were 12 co-founders from a lot of different countries, different resources, different already existing grassroots movements. And we just started to think, what can we do to future-proof Zurich? So the exercise we had was to find something where we can help to future-proof Zurich as an employer, also as an insurance company, but also in its role it plays in society. So we started all sharing the same vision with no strategy yet, no logo, no name. And what we came up during this 3 days was Next. So we just followed the strategy with a bit of different pillars than it is now, because for sure it has grown since this time. And it was an awesome experience because we all shared the same vision, being from totally different countries, doing totally different stuff in our daily work. We had senior support from day one because we had the pleasure to meet Mario, and he was really, really supportive for us doing this and growing as a movement. And then the next couple of months were just like walking themselves. We went to One Young World, which Nicoletta already mentioned, together with the Zurich Foundation, where we met awesome social leaders. We had scholars from the Zurich Foundation and Next Together who do awesome things and kind of social innovation in their countries. And we had buddies with them. And it was great to learn that there are people who are living in a lot more difficult circumstances, not a safe place like Zurich. Insurance, for example, is to grow your ideas, and they still made it to do a really great big change in their countries. So this was really inspiring and gave us power to work on our strategy with them together, actually, again, and grow as Next. So afterwards, we were even invited to the Zurich Global Leadership Team meeting back in winter 2019. We met Sebastian Zaldago, who is the co-founder of the Zurich Forest, and a lot of great senior leaders, where we had the chance to connect with them and get them on board to share our next vision. And we had a lot of people who connected with us afterwards and helped us, which are now, for example, mentors in the next change project. So it was a great experience. But suddenly, as every one of you know, then COVID came up and we had to all go back to virtual work, connect all virtually. We had new people joining the team, which we never saw before. For example, when I look at Natasha or Nicoletta, I work with them for a couple of months or years and I've never met them, but it kind of worked because we all shared the same vision. So we were all ready to maybe work some hours in the late evening or in the early morning because we really wanted to change something. Having in mind, we met this awesome scholars who had a lot more difficult circumstances and they still made a change. So this was really, really inspiring for every one of us. And then I also had the pleasure to be one of the first pilots of the Next Change program, which Suzy already introduced in advance. So I work together with Katja Pluto, who is our head of risk management for EMEA. And we did, like, as introduced, it's a cross mentoring or reverse mentoring. So I helped her to see the world more with the eyes of her, Gen Zler, actually, or someone out of the next gen, and helped her to understand a bit more what is going on in our generation, what is important to us, what can she keep more an eye of when she's doing business, etc. So it was really great. I'll also give her some hints from, like, a digital native, some more basic stuff, but this was more the bigger part. And she gave me, like, awesome tips and things I could change being, like, very young in the company and at this point actually leading a team of 12 international people at Next, and I was still, like, I think 23 at this moment, and I think this is not normal in companies like this, having the chance to talk to ex-com members, etc. So this was really enriching on both sides, I think. And then being the co-liaison at this point, and I haven't told you yet, I started as the communications co-lead for 1 year, and then I changed being the co-liaison together with Celine Bucha. And then I personally had a great time because I learned so much from myself, and on top really had the feeling to change something. And I think Next is changing a lot if we look back just 2 or 3 years and what we have reached already, that we are here together now having the time to talk about Next topics, being a future of work, future of customer centricity, whatever. And we have the time and plus on our daily job, so our line managers, our CEOs, whatever, give us the time. I think that shows how important Next is as a movement or to future-proof Zurich for the next generation. And yeah, as I said at the beginning, I'm now a Next alumni. I'm happy to be, because there are awesome people going on with the Next core team and also with the Next local hubs. And I think it's important to get some fresh minds into the movement. But I'm still carrying on the vision. We just released our next white paper. So Kara Wenger, the initial founder of Next, and Celine and myself. So if you're interested to read more about the history of Next and maybe what tips we would have for you if you want to grow your own grassroots movement outside of Zurich, and we really want to empower you to do so, to connect with our external connection leads, they are happy to help you and to grow your own movement. And maybe as I got the call right back in 2019, if I am interested to join Next, maybe you can grab your phone after today and call someone you know, and ask them to join some of the sessions with you on the next virtual summit, because there are great sessions coming up. Maybe connect with us afterwards, being it internal or externally, and grab yourself a coffee, maybe have a discussion afterwards. Because what I learned is that Next is great, but the most amazing part around it is to meet people who are like-minded like you, who really want to change something, and you can change something during this 2 years or even more than 2 years now. I never got negative feedback for bringing up my mind being a young person. People were always really supportive and thankful that we do what we do. So yeah, you need to be a bit brave, but as Natasha said, just say yes and try it and take your chance. And yeah, I would love to connect and love you to join all of the other sessions of the virtual summit. And I think with that, I'm giving it back to Next.
Hello. Hi, I'm Alex Spencer. I'm the current regional community builder for EMEA. I work alongside Araceli Cruz, who's the new regional community builder for the Americas as of today. So as Nicoletta mentioned earlier, there are 9 Next hubs in total. There's 4 in EMEA, 4 in the Americas, and 1 in APAC. Each of the hubs includes 2 local ambassadors, and that's my sort of main role, is to support the local ambassadors in each of those hubs in the implementation of the Next strategy that's been developed from a core perspective. it's a really interesting role because I get to have a view from both a core perspective and also from a local perspective and see how Next is implemented in each of the different hubs, which does vary quite a lot given the just like the cultural differences and also the way that, each business unit works. So it's been really interesting to be a part of. Another part of my role is also to kind of look to establish and develop new hubs in the regions. This has been evidenced like this year, there's been two new hubs, Italy and Brazil, which is really exciting and I think shows how Next is growing. So hopefully next year, Araceli and I can have the same success and develop some more hubs in those regions as well. So it's been a really interesting, exciting role and having that, being that interconnecting party between the local ambassadors and the core team is something that I've really enjoyed. And I think Next is a fantastic movement, being able to meet all the different people who have the same sort of views and want to make a real change. So it's been a really interesting, exciting 5 months so far that I've been part of this role. And I'll now pass to Jesus, who's the local ambassador for Spain. Thank you.
Thank you, Alex. I have the occasion to explain our first year as a local hub. I'm the Next local ambassador from Spain, and we started approximately 1 year ago with a call to other Zurich BU member to participate in a kickoff event. Before then, this kickoff event, we share with workplace and by mail and by every thing that we have to communicate, because in that time we were all at home. We invite them to participate in our kickoff event that plus than 800 people attended or in life in an event similar like that or later views. And we start to build our community here in Spain, as I say. When we were locked down, when we were at home, and was an opportunity to have a connection with different members of the company, with the similar pillars and structure than the core team has, and we are now more than 350 members that participate in our breakfast and learn, our initiative similar than core team, for example, Next Change, that we are local implanted in Spain, or in conversation with one of the main brokers in Spain that is our owner with external collection. And we try to involve to all the organization independently of their age, because Next core team says, it's not only because of your age, it's your attitude, is your way to see the possibilities of Zurich to change and be part of this future take us apart to participate. And one of the best things that we do since we start is to take that place, that seat on the table. And for example, we participate on an extended steering committee, like it's team, they say the team managers meeting. And we participate not as my voice or the voice of my partner as a local ambassador, Mireia. We want to take part of all the opinions from all these plus and 350 members, sharing them forms to know the opinion about the topic that we want to talk in that extended committee. And we want to involve to everyone in the company, everyone that have that feeling that Zurich have a lot of things to change and be part of that change. We invite them to take the voice and to share it with the people that made it possible now, and obviously to be part of this future. And one of these members now is Guillermo, and is part of the core team, and I take the voice to them. to him.
Thank you very much, Jesus, and hello everybody. I am Guillermo, a consultant in the OPEX team for Zurich, Spain, and member of NEXT as external connection co-lead along with Max. This has been just one of the many sessions that we have scheduled for this week. Today at 14, we have the panel discussion of the next generation of climate and earth with great guests from Coca-Cola, Zurich, and the SET Zurich Foundation. A little bit later, at 16 o'clock, we have a workshop session focused on building personal resilience. Tomorrow, we will continue at a quarter to 11, when we are going to talk about the climate change again with the guys from the team Malisa. At 15 o'clock, we will discover how to adapt our skills to be successful in the future, thanks to choosing your leaders from Zurich and Alexandra. On Wednesday at 9:30, we will have an interesting talk about diversity and why it's so important in life and in the companies. At 11:30, we will see again topics about climate change. For instance, we will talk about green IT and what it means and what we can do to make our companies a little bit more sustainable. At 1:30, we can learn how to reconcile work and personal life. On Thursday, we will have a session at 10:30, where we will talk about the future of the customer centricity. And we will close on Friday, first with a session about corporate health management at 13 with the founder of X30. And finally, our scholars will teach us how they manage to engage the next generation of leadership, service, and change. So before concluding, I would like to take a few last few minutes. If there is any question that you can send it to us to the chat, and we will be happy to answer it. And if not, that was all for the moment, but this has only just begun. It has been a pleasure to be here and see you in a few hours in the next session. Bye bye.
Thank you, Guillermo. And I would like to say thank you to all of our speakers. As already mentioned during our session, NEXT is a global initiative, and we are very delighted that we have speakers from Australia, but also that senior leaders from Zurich joined our talk today. And thank you very much for joining our opening session, and we are looking forward for our next session this afternoon to have a panel discussion about climate and earth. And if you take a look into the chat, you will see also our workplace groups of NEXT. If you would like to join our movement, then please give us a note and reach out to you, and we will give you feedback how you can join NEXT. Thank you very much, and we will see us later. Bye.